Walking around these walls, I thought by now they'd fall. For you have never failed me yet. Waiting for change to come, knowing the battle's won, when you have never failed me yet. Say your promise still stands, say
your promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness, your faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You never fail.
So your promise still stands.
Your promise still stands.
Yeah.
Great is your faithfulness, your faithfulness. Still in your hands, this is my confidence.
You never fail,
you never fail me, yeah.
Oh, no, you never failed, no. Oh, yes, I know the night won't last. Yes, your word will come to pass. For my heart will sing your praise again. Oh, Jesus, you're still enough. Keep me within your love. For my heart will sing your praise again. Yeah, sing your promise still stands.
Promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness, your faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You never fail me yet. Your promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness, your faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You never fail.
Bombing.
I'm standing here only because you made. You move mountains and you call the walls so far. And with your power, you perform miracles. There is nothing that's impossible. And I'm standing here only because you made.
And I'm standing here, sir.
And I'm standing here only because you made. And I'm standing here only because you made.
Every song we could ever sing, worthy of all the praise we could ever bring, worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you, oh, we live for you, Jesus. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever say, yeah. You're worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you, oh, we live for you. And we sing holy, say,
holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder. Show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those around me.
Sing.
Holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder. Show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those around me.
Cause you're worthy of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you, oh, we live for you. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever say. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you, yeah. Oh, we live for you. And we sing holy, say,
holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder. Show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love. Show me who you are and feel me is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder. Show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those around me. Truly, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my
solely on your love, God. Oh, yes, we will build our life. Yes, we will build our life on your love. Solely on your love, Lord. So let me be found with a heart, Lord, that longs after you, that longs after you, and may your eyes find me. Longing for you, all we want, yeah. So let me be found, Lord, with a heart longing for you and chasing for you. And may your eyes find me, God, longing for you. No one like you, Lord, in heaven and earth, no. So we pour out our praise, for you give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. And great are you, Lord, for it's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise. I pour out my praise. It's your breath in my lungs, God. So I pour out my praise to you only, yeah. For great are you, Lord. You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken, yeah. And great are you, Lord. And we all sing that it's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise. We pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out. Your breath. together say,
all the earth hears sounds of birth. Our hearts will cry, oh, these bones will sing. Great are you, Lord.
One more time we sing, all the earth.
All the earth will shout your
yes, our hearts will cry.
Our hearts will cry. Cause all that I have is a hallelujah, a hallelujah. And I know it's not much, but I'm nothing else fit for a king, except for a heart singing hallelujah, hallelujah. Because you are perfect in all of your ways. You
you are. Even when I don't live right, Lord, you are. Perfect in all of your ways, yes. You are perfect in all of your ways, to us.
Walk away, no matter what life may bring. matter what you face, you won't be lonely. Because forever is a long time. That's how long I'll love you. That's how long I'll love you. Forever. Forever is a long time. That's how long I'll love you. That's how long I'll love you. Forever. No matter what life may bring, I'll be by your side. No matter what you face, you won't be. Who give it this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
I do. As these two persons stand before us, it has become my responsibility to welcome you to this awesome event from the Benson, Dye, and Rutley families. We thank the Lord our God for your moral, for your physical and financial support for our daughter and son joining together in holy matrimony. We are led to believe that this act of God is not only his divine plan, but it is indeed his will for Kanita and Ryan to be joined together in this fashion. So with unlimited gratefulness, we thank God and thank you again, and we welcome you to this divine experience. Be safe and be blessed.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. You may be seated. At this time, we'll have a solo. Lord,
Bless you, Lord. At this time, we'll have the reading of the scriptures.
Genesis 1:26 through 27 says, "Then God said, 'Let us make man in our image, according to our likeness. They will rule the fish of the sea, the birds of the sky, the livestock, the whole earth, and the creatures that crawl on the earth.' So God created man in his own image. He created him in the image of God. He created them, male and female." Genesis 2:21 through 24 reads, "So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to come over the man, and he slept. And God took one of his ribs and closed the flesh at that place. Then the Lord God made the rib he had taken from the man into a woman and brought her to the man. And the man said, 'This one at last is bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. This one will be called woman, for she was taken from man.' This is why man leaves his father and his mother and bonds with his wife, and they become one flesh." Amen.
I'll be reading Ephesians chapter 5, 22 to 28. "Wives, submit to your own husband as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, his body, and is himself its Savior. Now, as the church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit in everything to their husbands. Husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her, that he might sanctify her, having cleansed her by the washing of water with the word, so that he may present the church to himself in splendor without spot or wrinkle or any such thing, that she might be holy and without blemish." Verse 28, "In the same way, husbands should love their wives as their own bodies, for he who loves his wife loves himself." The word of the Lord.
This is the word of the Lord from Matthew 28:18 to 20. "Jesus came near and said to them, All authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and in the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. And on this day, which is Pentecost Sunday, it is also the International Day to remember the least reached, the unreached, who don't have access to the gospel. Maybe not in their own language of the Bible or any witness. And so we give this charge and we bless you, Kanita and Ryan, in this marriage, and all of us here who stand as part of the body of Christ, to live out this charge together for the glory of God and for the salvation of all peoples, that we might stand together at the end of the day, at the end of the age, praising our Heavenly Father from every tongue and tribe and people and language. And may it begin with a wave of His Spirit out from here and blessings on this couple. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Dearly beloved, we are gathered together here in the sight of God, and in the face of this company, to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is honorable, an honorable estate instituted of God, signifying unto us the mystical union between the church and Christ, which holy estate Christ adorned and beautified with his presence and first miracle that he wrought in Cana and Galilee. It is commended of Saint Paul, and to be honorable among all, and therefore should not be by any entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, soberly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, these two persons present come now to be joined. If anyone can show just cause why they may not be lawfully joined, let him now speak, or else hereafter forever hold his peace. Amen. I require and charge you both, as you will answer in that dreadful day of judgment, when the secrets of all hearts shall be disclosed, that if either of you know any impediment why ye may not be lawfully joined together in matrimony, you do now confess it. For be ye well assured that if any persons are joined together otherwise, then as God's word does allow, that marriage is not lawful. Ryan, will you agree and assent to these words? Ryan, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together in God's ordinance after the holy estate of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor her, and keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keep you only unto her so long as you both shall live?
I absolutely do, yes.
Amen. Kanita, will you have this man to be thy wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy state of matrimony? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keeping you only unto him so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Amen. Amen. At this time, Kanita and Ryan have vows that they want to share with each other before this gathered assembly.
Okay.
Ryan, you are the embodiment of God's perfect love for me. A miracle I never knew would happen. My king, my protector, my provider, my love, my best friend, my comedian, and my confidant. From the moment we shared our first conversation, you were my safe place. And that first conversation that we had, I knew you were my husband, the man that I had prayed for decades. You were in my life. And for that, I'm grateful. You have been the answer to the lifelong prayer for a spiritual covering and priest of my home. And I'm forever grateful and indebted to the goodness of God for you. I vow to love you and serve you for as long as I live. I vow to be your greatest cheerleader, your greatest confidant, your unending support. Our marriage will be a shining symbol, an example of God's glory unveiled in the earth. Our legacy will be one of kingdom building, kingdom discipleship, and kingdom soul winning for the glory of God alone and to the nations of the world. I love you, baby. I will live every day of my life thanking you for choosing me as your good thing.
I'm a little crazy, but I've been encouraged to not be crazy today. All jokes aside, I thank God that the Word of God says that those that are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. I wasn't chasing you, and even though I pursued you, more than pursuing you, I was led to you. And so that confirms you're marrying a son of God. I honor the Lord that today, not only in this place on a beach, but back into the Garden of Eden, I went to sleep and I woke up with a wife. It is indeed an honor to serve you as your best friend, as your lover, as your protector, as your provider. Led by the Spirit of God, I realized that all of the choices don't matter. When the Lord spoke to me in looking for a wife, a choice is the decision between two people or two or more options. But a decision is when all other options are dissipated and I'm only left with the decision. So today you are not a choice, you are a decision. I love you, I honor you, and for the rest of my life, will I now make a decision to honor you, to honor the Lord? I didn't know that in order to have everything, it would cost me everything. The Bible says, who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. And honey, you're not just a stone. You're my ruby. I love you, and for the rest of our days, to be the best of our days. Amen. Yeah. Hallelujah. Woo.
Not yet.
Not yet. Dad on steroids. Amen, amen. At this time, we'll have a solo. We'll have a solo.
However, it's on when it's all right. Amen. Amen. Would you take Kanita's right hand, Ryan, with your right hand? Amen. Repeat after me. I, Ryan.
Take thee, Kanita.
To be my wedded wife. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer or poorer. For sicker. For sickness. And health, to love and cherish till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance, I thereto pledge my faithfulness. Kanita, would you take Ryan's right hand? She's obedient.
I, Kanita,
take thee, Ryan, to be my wedded husband,
to have and to hold,
from this day forward, for better or for worse,
for richer or for poorer,
in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, to death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance,
I thereto give you my loyalty. Amen. Amen. At this time, we're going to exchange rings. Amen. We're going to start with Ryan giving Kanita her ring. And you're going to put it partially on at this time. Okay. Obedience is better than sacrifice.
Yes, sir. I got you.
Repeat these words after me. With this ring, I thee wed in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. 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 Kanita. With this ring, I thee wed in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. You can turn in my direction. Ephesians 5 was read in our hearing. And the verse that wasn't included is what makes everything that follows possible. In Ephesians 5, verse 18, the Bible says, be filled with the Spirit and not drunk with wine. I know some of you say, see, he didn't say you can't drink. And all that I'm going to say after I share an embarrassing experience, coldest day of the year, urgent call to go to the hospital. I run to my car, heading to this urgent situation. Car doesn't start. Check battery, the alternator, everything was working, the horn, the lights, etc., and I couldn't figure out what it was. All I knew is I was supposed to be at the hospital. The car wasn't working. Ultimately, after standing out in the cold for about 30 minutes, I called AAA. Somebody already gave my story away. Guess what? The car had no gas. Somehow, in the hurriedness of getting into the house, I left my car running all night. Now, don't tell anybody I told you that. There was nothing wrong with the car. The problem was it didn't have any gas. There is nothing wrong with marriage. The problem is, it doesn't lack gas, but it lacks the filling of the Holy Spirit. But before you can have the Spirit, Jesus said, except a man is born of the water and of the Spirit, he cannot see God. You can't comprehend God. You can't have a relationship with God. But as many as receive Jesus, to them he gives the right. And then you are indwelled. The Holy Spirit takes up residency in us. Unlike gas in the car that can run out, we never run out of the Holy Spirit. But in order to be filled, it means to be activated. The gas of the Holy Spirit is always residing in Christians. We just need to allow the Spirit to enable us, because it's not by might or by our human power, but it's by the Spirit. So we need to be activated. We need to be captivated. That means controlled by and motivated by the Spirit of God. So before you can be led and controlled, activated, motivated, and captivated, you need to have a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. Nothing is wrong with marriage. When we understand that the gas that makes marriage run the way God intends, then we can do what verse 21 says, submit one to another. Voluntarily place yourself under the authority of one another according to the roles that God has already ordained. And guess what? God created marriage. He has the blueprint and all the instructions that we need to make marriage work. Wives, when you're submitting to your own husband, that means that you will recognize him as a spiritual covering, that you will recognize his voice in your life is the voice of Christ. The Bible says, obey your husband in everything unless he tells you to do something that disagrees with the word of God. Submit to your husband. I talked to a lady. She said that she was really, really upset when her counselor had asked her to complete an assignment. She was about to divorce her husband. She was a great wife in her own mind. She came in, the counselor said, I want you to make a list of everything that you do for your husband. And she had 3 pages typed on both sides of all the things she did for her husband on a regular basis. And then the counselor looked over all of the individual detailed things the wife said she did that made her a great wife. And then she took a bright red marker and put an X across every page. She said the one word that is missing that every man needs from his wife is to be respected. A man would rather be disrespected than to feel like you love him. You don't love him until you respect him. That means that you will follow his godly leadership. You will cover his nakedness, his weakness, not ignore them, not pretend that they don't exist, but will discreetly help your husband to learn how to grow in those areas where he's failing. Respect your husband by honoring him in public, complimenting him in public, complimenting him in public. Treat your husband like a man. He's not your girlfriend. He's not a child, even when we act like children sometimes. You will make us very angry if you treat us like we're a child. Respect your husband and God will bless your marriage. Meet your husband's physical needs without an appointment. Don't make it complicated. Don't make it a reward. Do it as a devotion as unto the Lord. And God will give you a man who's crazy enough to think he can climb Mount Everest for you, swim across the Atlantic Ocean for you, run a 100-yard dash in 8.1 seconds. That's the kind of man that you will find Ryan to be, That's record time. We'll be trying it, even when we old, when we are respected. Ryan, the Bible says, love your wife as Christ loved the church. He loved the church so much that he willingly gave his life for her. Even though she had spots and blemishes, flaws, he gave his life for her. The most important gift that you can give your wife is not a new car, not a new house. She needs you. Give her the gift of your quality time. Give her the gift of making her your priority. Give her the gift that the scripture tells us as you read through that Ephesians 5 passage. Give her the gift of being her provider. She might even make more than you, but she needs to know that if you got to get it done, she doesn't have to worry about it because you will make it happen. She can lean on your shoulder. You will provide for her. You will constantly try to improve yourself financially for the betterment of your family. You will not remain stagnant. You will not sit in the background and let your wife accomplish great things while you chill. Ryan, protect your wife. Oh, I'm good. I'm good with my hands. I'm an expert. No. Protect her emotionally. The Bible says that to live with your own wife according to understanding. Know your wife. The Bible says that she's a weaker vessel. That doesn't mean that she's inferior or less than. It means that she is a rare commodity. Treat her like a jewel. Treat her like a rose, a flower, a delicate thing. Treat her like she's your queen. Ryan, you are your wife's pastor. Her first pastor is not the one she visits on a Sunday. You are your wife's pastor. You are her spiritual covering. Don't send your wife to church, and I know you don't do that. Brothers, don't send your wife to church and say, I'm represented. No. You are the leader. God will start with judgment with you, brothers. You are the priest of your home, the pastor of your home, but you also are the prophet of your home. You can't lead nobody if you don't know where you're going, if you don't know who you is. So the Bible says, without vision, the people cast off restraints. They lack direction. A woman just want to know where we going. I think we've been around this mountain 4 or 5 times. Are we going forward? Even if it's with small incremental steps, we got to be moving somewhere. So give vision to your marriage. Ryan, pleasure your wife. Not only going to be your protector, provider, priest, and prophet, pleasure this woman. This is my daughter. What I mean by that, because brothers already, I ain't got no problem with that. Yeah, we can go right now. No. I'm talking about flirting with her, dating her. Telling her how beautiful she is. Surprising her with the kind of rap that you had today, bro. Keep on rapping. Keep on making her know that she is special in your eyes. And no matter what the years bring, Ryan, she will always be beautiful to you, and he will always be your handsome king. Amen. At this time, we're going to have a duet followed by Pastor Mugo. We're going to have communion, and then Pastor Mugo is going to pray. Pastor Mugo is Kanita's spiritual father from East Africa, Kenya. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Say, brought me from a mighty long way, and now today I can testify that I believe it. I'm on my way, realizing. realizing he's the one who kept me when the storms of life arise, sleepless nights and desperate cries. He's captured every tear, assuring me that he hears every prayer, waiting on the answer, only to discover he is near and he hears every prayer. For he's done great things. I believe he's the God who always answers prayer. Prayer. I heard him say, prayers of the righteous availeth much. I'm on my way. I can testify that I believe it.
On my way, I want to let you know that he will keep you when the storm. He's a God who always.
I believe he's a God always.
I believe he's a God who always answers prayer. Oh, he answers prayer.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen. At this time, we're going to have the communion. And following communion, Pastor Mogo will come and give a prayer of charge. Amen.
For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you show forth his death and his suffering. We ain't messing up no makeup today. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Not today. Amen. Drink. Amen. Welch's. Welch's. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. Pastor Mogo, would you come?
Amen. Praise the Lord. This is the Lord's doing, and it's marvelous in our eyes. Let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I thank you and bless you for gathering your servants from this nation, bringing together family, parents of Kanita and Rayan, and all those that have come to witness this union. Lord, I want to say thank you for giving each one of us journey mercies and giving us peace, and even for all the logistics that took place for us to be here. I want to say thank you. Thank you, Lord, for this is a journey that started with one step, and for them to be where we are today, we give you the praise, we give you the glory, we give you the honor. Lord, I pray for your divine favor upon their lives as they begin this journey. I pray for your peace, peace that the world cannot receive, peace that passes all human understanding in their marriage. I pray for your grace and mercy. I pray for your blessings. I also pray that you kept them and their family in your perfect love. Yes. And to Rayan and Kanita, may the Lord bless you. Yes. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you. Yes. And be gracious unto you. Yes. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. I pray all this believing and trusting in the very precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Yes. Amen. Amen. Mungu awabariki.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, sir.
Bless you, sir. Bless you. Bless you. Bless you. Praise the Lord. Amen. I don't know how to say that. But what I do want to say as we do come to a close is this is my daughter, my only daughter. And I just want to commend all of you who have poured into her life. You have made your way here, but this is a woman who has been discipled by many. And she is who she is because of your commitment to Jesus Christ. I often teach her and I say, sweetie, when I grow up, I want to be just like you. She loves Jesus. And I'm so grateful that she waited. She had reached the point in her walk with the Lord where Jesus was really enough. And God decided otherwise. And so I helped her pack.
Yes, you
did. With many, many tears. Many tears. She is a warrior for the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Ryan is Kanita's dad on steroids. He is an amazing man of God. Great faith. And throughout this weekend, I was trying to get him to not worry about us. but he was trying to make sure everybody was okay. And I hope that you're here in this moment, brother, because this is your day. I trust you with my daughter. I anticipate great and mighty things from this relationship because of the level of commitment the two of you have to the Lord. They are soul winners. Amen. So I love you, my wife, Virginia, Anita, Kim, we love you. We love you very much. And we're all here. We're here for you in any way that we can be of support to you.
Is this the kissing part?
No. Those who God has joined together, let no one separate. For as much as Ryan and Kanita have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and this company, and thereto have given their pledge to be faithful each to another, and have declared the same by giving and receiving rings and by joining hands, I now pronounce that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. You may now, at this time, salute your bride. Amen, 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 amen. Amen, 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 amen. He's getting some power. Uh-oh. I now present to some for the first time, Mr. and Miss Ryan and Kanita Rutley, and for others who have been this way before, I present to you them again, Ryan and Kanita Rutley. God bless you. Amen. Amen. Would you stand? Would you stand and encourage them? Amen. Amen.
Like a fool, I went and